Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to learn lesson number 6, and this one is a fourth video, right? In which we learn transportation in plants and animals. In plants, xylem and phloem we are going to learn in a detail. While in animals, blood circulatory system, lymphatic system, excretory system, and in blood circulatory system we learn hearts and platelets in a detail each one. Now structure of human heart, but let us compare with that our transportation system in our body, alright, and in our house. If you want to transport in our house water, what do you need? Transportation. Second thing, what do you need? Transportation machine. That is nothing but in our body. And in our house consist of electric motor that transport water from ground level to that tank. Clear? First part. Similar way, if you want to transport something in our body, then transportation system plus machine is required. So in our body, transportation machine is human heart. Why do you need this? For the transportation of water, electric motor is required. Similarly, if you want to transport like oxygen, carbon dioxide, hormones, nutrients, all the different things if you want to transport, then you need transportation and transporting machine, that is human heart. Let us see, with help of human heart, the transportation is done by using blood. So blood also consists of broadly two parts. First one is cellular part and second one is fluid. The cellular part we are familiar, WBC, RBC, and so other things are there. While that fluid also called as plasma, right? So plasma transport food, then carbon dioxide, nitrogen, salt, and so many other things. While the cellular part mainly it transport oxygen with help of hemoglobin. Now next, why do you need this one? Why do you need? Because we want to transport these at different organs. Where we want to transport? At a different organs. And also we want to reach at the tissue and every cell. For that transportation is required. Again, one more thing here. To repair that different parts, if it is injury are there, then we have to reach at that particular place to repair it. So for repair also this transportation is required. Now next, a structure of human heart. See, this one is made up of muscles, that's why it is called as muscular structure. And size wise, just you have to measure your fist, that much size is your human heart. Then that total how many chamber there? 4 chambers. So from that right side and left side you have to count. Right side that right atrium, left side left atrium. Right side right ventricle, left side left ventricle. In this way total 4 chamber. But along with that some more things are there, this superior vena cava and inferior vena cava that collects blood from that different parts. Superior collect from that anterior region while inferior collect from that lower part region. Pulmonary artery that give blood to that lungs, that we'll learn in detail why it is pulmonary, why it is artery. The next, pulmonary vein that collects blood from lungs. And between this one, different walls are there. This also you can see, this one walls are there. And between these two chambers, there is a portion are there that is called as septa, that separate different chambers from each other. Next, this again you can see the structure of human, one more diagram I have taken. Okay, now circulation in human heart. We have to consider first blood which is given to that all the organ in which oxygen is utilized. So now blood become deoxygenated, right, without oxygen. For that oxygen, to carry oxygen, it has to go to the lungs and from that it will carry oxygen. Getting there? So now let us consider the path. I have divided this into 5 steps. First, blood from organ, it will go to that right side, right atrium. From right side, it will go to that right ventricle. From ventricles that will go to that lungs to carry oxygen. Now from lungs again that will come to that left atrium. Now from lungs this will reach to that left atrium. From left atrium that will come to the left ventricle. From left ventricle that will go to that again organs, or that will distribute it to that organs. Getting here? Again let us see this with help of simple diagram I have drawn. From organ blood is coming to that right atrium. From right atrium that will come to that right ventricle. From right ventricle that will come to the lungs to carry oxygen. Now oxygen is carried in blood, so that will reach to that left atrium. From left atrium again that will come to that left ventricle. From left ventricle again that will distributed to the organs. In this way blood is circulated from organ to heart, and from heart to that lungs, and from lungs again it is distributed to different organs. In this way that blood is coming two times. This one is first time, again it is coming second time. That's why this is called as a double circulation. Is it clear? Very simple. Next, now that three term also you have to understand. Between these chambers there is valves are given, right? These valves are given, that is ensure that blood will not flow in the reverse direction. So that's why these valves are given in between these atrium and now next one is pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein. Here we need to understand what is artery and what is vein. I hope whenever first any time students has been asked what is artery and what is vein, then student directly answered that artery means that distributed oxygenated blood and vein means that collect deoxygenated blood, right? That is not the correct way to describe artery and vein. So correct way description of artery and vein is artery means that gives or distribute blood away from heart, that is called as artery. While vein means that collect blood towards that heart, that is called as vein. Is it clear? So now look at here, artery and vein. If we talk about this one is going towards lungs, anything related to lungs are called as pulmonary. That part you have to remember. Related to heart it is called as cardiac. Related to kidney is called as renal. So similar way here that we are talking about lungs, all right? So here away from heart it is called as artery. Getting here? Away from artery this one is called as artery. Towards heart it is called as vein. Is it clear? But related to the lungs are called as pulmonary. Related to the lungs are called as pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein. Now look at here whether it is oxygenated or deoxygenated. Now this blood is collected deoxygenated. So this artery is collecting or distributing that deoxygenated blood. Exception, all the artery carries oxygenated blood, but this one, see here, from heart to going to the lungs to carry oxygen, and this is without oxygen. So that's why pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood, while pulmonary veins here from lungs it is carrying oxygen and distributing to that heart. So this one is oxygenated blood. Remember this part, exception. So all the vein collect deoxygenated blood, all the artery carries oxygenated blood, but two exception, pulmonary artery distributes deoxygenated blood while pulmonary vein distribute oxygenated blood. Is it clear? All right, next. Double circulation already we have discussed that two times blood is coming in a heart, it is called as double circulation. See here, in that bird, mammals and higher level organism, that total four chamber are there. Why it is four chamber? That required maximum amount of oxygen, that blood has to be or body has to be remain higher temperature, or body has to maintain temperature. That's why that required separate four chamber. oxygenated and deoxygenated blood should not be mixed with each other. All right. So that's why that four chambers are there in birds. They are flying, more energy is required. They are also required higher energy. Similar with mammals also, right? To ensure these things, to requirement fulfill, that four chambers are separated each other. That also called as warm-blooded animals. While in amphibians and reptiles, three chambers are there. How many chambers? Three chambers, where little bit mixing of blood takes place, of oxygenated and deoxygenated. Body temperature varies with temperature. See, our body, whether it is summer or there, winter is there, still our body try to maintain 30 degree Celsius. And that's why we are called as warm-blooded animal. It does not vary according to temperature of the surrounding. While reptiles and amphibians, three-chambered heart are there, they could not maintain temperature according to that body. That varies according to environment. As environment temperature varies, that body temperature varies. That is there in amphibians and reptiles. That is called as cold-blooded animals. While birds and mammals are called as warm-blooded animal that maintain temperature, whether it is outside more or less, approximately in human beings 38 is maintained. While in that fish only two chambers are there. How many? Only two chambers, and blood circulate only once. That type of circulation is called as single circulation, and blood goes once in a heart. Right? Okay. Now next, capillaries. See here that we talk about artery and veins to the different heart to organs, but at the organ level that has to be distributed all that blood cell tissues. Take example, whenever our skin is injured, whenever it is cut, what is happening? Blood is coming. But whenever you go to that doctor, they give the injection, they try to find out where is that particular artery or vein. Alright? So that all these our body parts consist of capillaries that supplies very small blood vessels, that is capillaries. Getting here? So now what is that, this capillary characteristic? That connection between arteries and veins, that artery distribute and vein collect, at the time that connection is formed, that is called as capillaries. Walls are one cell thick. Thickness of these capillaries is only one cell. Why? Because they want to supply, they want to distribute that oxygen, other nutrients at the different organs. That's why how much it is thickness? Only one cell thickness of arteries, or sorry, capillaries are there. So that easy exchange of blood material is possible. The smallest vessels, blood vessels, artery vessels, all these things we are talking about, the capillaries are the smallest vessel in our body. Exchange of material between the blood and surrounding organ and tissues, for that these capillaries are useful. Difference between arteries and vein, already I have given first difference, that arteries carry blood away from heart, it goes away, while it goes towards the heart. That is called as vein, and this one is called as artery. This part you have to remember, right? Don't define with help of oxygenated and deoxygenated. Second difference are called as distributing vessels, that generally it distribute to the different organs. That's why it is called as distributing vessels, while this one collect blood towards heart, it is called as collecting vessels. This already we have discussed, all the arteries carries oxygenated blood except pulmonary artery. All these vein carries deoxygenated blood except pulmonary vein. Alright, that we have discussed. That arteries are deep-seated compared to vein. Arteries are high pressure. It has to distribute to the different organs. That's why they are under high pressure. Compared to this one, just it is collecting, so low pressure. While as again we are talking about under high pressure, the thickness is more than that vein. As again it is under pressure, so it is elastic, while comparative less elastic. look at here, that under this vein they are low pressure only collecting, so blood may go in a reverse direction. That's why valves are present to prevent the backflow of blood, right? While this one is under pressure, so wall are not required, and without wall arteries are there. Clear? So in this, a total 9 points are there in difference between arteries. Again, three differences with help of diagram. See here, this one is artery, this one is vein, and third one is capillaries. Arteries, that thick wall under pressure, elastic wall, and lumen is smaller, so that it will go with help of pressure. I hope you are familiar, whenever you are spraying water, what do? You reduce that lumen of the pipe. Similar way, to create pressure, lumen should be smaller. Similar way, vein, that thin wall, right, and lumen is larger, and in between walls are present in vein. While capillaries are single cell for that easy distribution of blood and that surrounding. Clear? Okay. Next, platelets. I have written in a sequence wise, if you get injury in a particular part, what happened? Next is start bleeding. Then bleeding, loss of blood. Pressure is decreases as it is inside, blood is released, bleeding is there, pressure decreases, so that our pumping system affected with help of decrease in a blood. Because of these things, the plug the leaks, wherever the leakage is there, it is plug, it is a close with help of platelets. At which place? At arteries and vein. By which thing? By clotting the blood. That is main function is of platelets. You can see that whenever any leakage is there, particular system is formed with help of platelets, that is called as a clotting, right? Next, the diagram, you can see lymphatic system, right? Let us sequence wise, when some amount of plasma from the blood, protein cells are escaped into intercellular space through the pores present in the wall of capillaries. As we say that arteries distribute and vein collect. At the time, these are the formation of capillaries. At the time, some leakage are there. What is leakage? Leakage of plasma, protein, and some cells. That part is called as lymph, right? Through the pores of capillaries, right? What is composition of this lymph? It is colorless, similar to the plasma, but what is the difference? Contain less amount of protein than plasma. It flows in the lymphatic system. Where it is, particular system are there, that is called as lymphatic system in that flow. Now see one by one this sequence, same thing. Capillaries are there. During what is happening? Leakage. What is leakage? That lymph. That lymph is now reached to that intercellular space of the tissue. Tissue are in our body. Through that leakage, that lymphatic capillaries now involve lymphatic system. It is collected in lymphatic capillaries. From lymphatic capillaries, it is collected in lymphatic vessels. From lymphatic vessels, now again it get back to that our circulatory system in large vein, in the blood, right? So in this way, that collection of this lymph is there. What is the function? Function of this lymph? Transportation. First function is transportation. It carries digested and absorbed fat from intestine. See the first. What is that? Digested fat and absorbed fat from intestine. Then it takes excess fluid from the intercellular space. In our intercellular space, in which fluid is there, that is again collected with help of lymph. In this way, main two functions are there. Now, next one is transportation in plants. Already we said xylem and phloem we are going to discuss. First, transportation of substance from one part to another part within a plant body. We have discussed in animal, now this one is in plants. If it is small distance are there, then that diffusion is sufficient enough, right? With help of diffusion, it can be transported at small distance. But if it is large distance, you are familiar, very, very large height in a palm tree, is it possible with help of diffusion? No. then what is particular, just like pumping system is required in a plant, that is xylem and phloem with help of a system. Next, xylem, we are familiar, always have to remember xylem means transportation of water. Let us take one by one. It is present in root, stem and leaves. Everywhere we need transportation of water, this xylem is present. Transfer water and dissolved substances from root to that aerial part. What are the components? Last year you have learned, consist of, it is complex tissue, so it is made up of different type of tissue. Tracheids are there, vessels, third one xylem parenchyma, and fourth one is xylem sclerenchyma. The transport of xylem is unidirectional, only one direction it is possible. Now we are going to discuss in a two parts, in the lower plants and in higher plant. Let us see first water transportation by xylem in a lower plants. Look at here, xylem and all the organ are interconnected by continuous system, just like pipe system. If you are familiar with that drip irrigation, all things are connected with help of pipes, in where that it is continuous system is present there. Root cells and soil are directly connected. I have drawn here diagram. This is soil and this one is root. They are directly connected. We know that we saw, we grew that this plant inside soil. So they are directly connected. Root take up some iron from soil, right? This root takes some iron first from the soil. What happened then? Difference is created between soil and root. Ionic difference here, more ions are now reached there. Because of this, now root having more concentration of iron. Iron is reached in the root, so that more concentration are. So water move from soil to root. Now water is start moving from root, soil to root, because of concentration differences is there. That again you have learned in last year. This create column. This lead to the create column, and transportation is done at lower plant. Very simple with help of this diagram, right? Now next, in higher plant, listen carefully here. What is happening? Higher level plant, when adequate water is available, stomata loses water. When more amount or adequate amount of water is present, then this stomata loses water from this stomatal pore. This lost water is replaced by xylem vessel. This one is xylem vessel. This lost water is replaced by xylem vessels. Evaporation of water molecule from leaves created suction. As it is, evaporation from this one lead to the suction pump. Just like our electric pump, suction is created. So here suction is created, which pull the water from root to xylem, right? From this pumping system, what is created? Suction is created and water is transported from root to that aerial part with help of xylem, right? Now next, transpiration. Loss of water from the aerial part, from this aerial part. Transpiration regulate temperature. This also regulate temperature. Stomata opens daytime. Daytime stomata is open, so that transpiration become major driving force during the daytime, right? Now next, with this lesson is completed. Homework, listen carefully. You have to ask application level, thinking level, practical level questions in comment box. Compulsory. And remaining students will answer for the same questions, and that will be counted in your internal marks. Is it clear? With this, our today's video is over. Thank you very much. Bye bye. See you again in next video.